So how can we, cotton is extracted from an agricultural field where cotton crop will be grown and the fruit of the cotton will be cotton ball. After harvesting the cotton ball, the cotton from the cotton ball the seeds will be separated and the cotton fibers will be separated by hand. Then after separation of these fibers, next process will be spinning cotton yarn, that means making that fibers into long thread like structures and bundles of threads called yarn. Okay, so how is the spinning done? So there are something called hand spinning. How is hand spinning done? In a left hand, take a cotton ball, right? Then in the right hand, between the thumb and the forefinger, pull out a thread and continuously twist it. While pulling, do the twisting process continuously. So take a cotton ball in one hand, that is imagine your left hand, and then pinch some between the thumb and the forefinger of the other hand. Start pulling the cotton while continuously twisting. You have to pull like this, and while pulling you have to twist it also. This forms a yarn, this forms a thread like structure, understood, right? Take a cotton ball, pull it with the right hand with the help of a thumb and the forefinger, and while pulling continuously twist it. So it forms a thread like structure called yarn. Then these fibers together form a yarn. So spinning process, what is the definition of spinning process? The process of making yarn from the cotton fibers, that will be the definition of spinning. The process of making yarn from the cotton fibers, how it is done? By taking a cotton ball in your left hand and then pulling the cotton, pulling small fibers from the cotton and twisting it and making a thread while continuously pulling with the two fingers of your right hand. It forms a thread like structure. These thread like structures together form yarn. Then from this yarn fabric will be woven, that means cloth pieces will be woven. So fibers form yarn and yarn forms a fabric, right? Then other than hand spinning, there is one more hand spinning method called tapli. It is also done with hands. It is a simple device used in olden days. It uses a hand spindle. It is a J, you know, alphabet J, right? J alphabet, it stands for joker, J for joker. So this tapli device also looks like a J-shaped alphabet. It is nothing but a steel device which is J-shaped, through which hand spinning is done. Then we have something called charkha. Charkha is a hand operated device, again used with hand. Then used for spinning of yarn, that is cotton fibers are spinned into yarn. Then it was popularized by Mahatma Gandhi. Mahatma Gandhi used to say that don't use imported fabric which used to be made in Britain. Use the Indian fabric. The cotton fabric which was made with the help of charkha. So in that charkha, cotton ball was taken and that it would be woven into yarns or fibers, then it would be woven into fabric. So he used to advise everybody in India to use cotton clothes and use hand woven fabrics rather than using the imported jeans of all those Britain people. So that is how charkha got popular. Charkha is nothing but a wheel like structure. With one hand, with the right hand the wheel will be rotated, and with the left hand the cotton fibers will be introduced into the wheel. So all these three methods are hand spinning methods: hand spinning, tapli and charkha. Now we have something called machine spinning. Suppose if we want cotton yarns on a large scale, suppose you are having a ready-made business or a cloth business or a big factory or a wholesale business, then we need machines. Then at that instances machine spinning will be done. So on a large scale it will be done with machines, with the help of machines. And then these yarns will be used for making fabrics, different kinds of fabrics, pants, shirts, saris, dress materials, anything. So that is about the spinning cotton yarn. Now you have spun into a yarn, then how does this yarn go to form a fabric or a big cloth piece? So weaving and knitting are the two processes from which fabric will be formed from a yarn. Understood? Weaving and knitting are the two processes from which fabric will be developed from a yarn. So what is weaving? Weaving is nothing but process of arranging two sets of yarns together to make a fabric. In weaving, two sets of yarns will be used. In knitting, only single set of yarn will be used, right? And weaving and knitting are used both to make varieties of clothes. So the yarn bundles will be made into fabrics, like different cloth structures which will be continuous. So weaving is a process of arranging two sets of yarns together to make a fabric or a cloth piece. This weaving is of two types, either hand or by machines. So if it is done by hand, it is called hand-loom process. So the weaving is done by something called looms. The machines are known as looms. So if it is done by hand, it is known as hand loom. We get hand loom saris everywhere in the exhibitions and everywhere, right? So those are nothing but hand woven saris. So that is why they will be much costlier. So those are hand loom, weaving of cotton fibers by hand to form a fabric or a cloth piece. Then in the looms, the weaving is also done by machines or with the help of power operated, with the help of electricity. So the fabric or the cloth will be developed from yarn. So how is this done? With the help of two processes, like weaving and knitting. So these two processes help to make us different varieties of clothes, like saris, dress materials, kids wear, everything. So weaving is a process of arranging two sets of yarns together to form a fabric or a cloth. Weaving is done by something called looms. These looms are of two types, either hand operated or power operated. The hand operated one is called hand loom. That means the total cloth will be woven by hand. Then either it is machine or power operated. Then the next is knitting. In knitting, only single yarn is used to make a fabric. In weaving, two sets of yarns are used. In knitting, only a single set of yarn is used. If you have ever observed your mothers or grandmothers weaving a sweater, they take a woolen bundle, they take a needle, and only single set of thread will continuously weave your complete sweater. So that is how the knitting of the sweaters is done. Then with the help of wool, knitting is done, right? So knitting, with the help of knitting, we can make woolen clothes, sweaters, socks, shawls, hand gloves, etc. So single yarn is used to make a fabric. The types are both hand knitting and machine knitting. Suppose you are doing on a small scale for your relatives, then you do with hand, with the help of a needle. Then if you are doing on a large scale, manufacturing unit if you have, then you do knitting on a, with the help of machines. Then the uses of knitting are to knit the woolen clothes like sweaters and socks. Suppose if ever your sweater or socks is torn and you see a strand of thread coming out and you start pulling that thread, it will only be a one single strand of thread. That is how it shows the knitting is done with a single yarn. That means only one single thread only does all the total process of making the fabric. So this is how yarn is made into a fabric, and then weaving and knitting process makes fabrics, and these fabrics are further used to make varieties of clothes available in the market. History of clothing material. So earlier in the ancient times, the man was a nomad. He didn't have much knowledge, right? So in olden times, big leaves like banana leaf, if you have ever observed, it is a big leaf, right? The structure, the size will be big. Then barks of the trees means the brown colored part of the tree trunk, that is the bark of the tree. Animal skins of wild animals. Then furs of the animals means, suppose you know bear, you know fox, right? The skin is usually having lots of hairs and helps us to keep the body warm. So if anytime the animal dies, they take out the skin of the animal, that is known as the fur. So all these things were used to cover the body because they didn't have much knowledge. Because now we are all studying, you are all science students, you know what is, why everything is happening and how everything was discovered, because you are studying, whereas the ancient people didn't have any knowledge of anything, right? So that's the reason they used to cover themselves with big leaves, parts of the trees, animal skins and furs. Then after agriculture came into existence, that means cultivation of crops came into existence. Until the agriculture was not there, the ancient people used to eat the fruits which were available on the trees, right? And they used to burn the animals on the firewood and used to eat. So after agriculture came into existence, the mats and baskets were started to be weaving. How the mats and baskets were weaved? With the help of stems, leaves and twigs of the plants, right? Then after agriculture came into existence, with the help of leaves, twigs, stems, mats and baskets were weaved. Then later, vines. What do you understand by vine? We talk of grape vines, right? Grape vines means some plants act as climbers. So grape tree is also a climber. It has spindle-shaped, spring-shaped structures which crawl over other trees, right? So that are nothing but vines. Vines are nothing but climbers. Grape vines, example is grape vine. Vines are nothing but climbing plants. Animal fleece, animal hair. Animal fleece and hair are almost similar. Here fleece means the sheep. The sheep has a layer of hair over it, which will be later used for producing wool. So that is known as the animal fleece, the upper covering of the skin. animal fleece is nothing but the skin, outer covering of the skin, outer covering of the body of the animals. That is animal fleece. Then hair of the animals were woven into fabrics. Later, animal hairs, animal skins, climbing trees, all these things were taken and woven into fabrics, made into cloths. Then after some time, cotton also came into existence. You know Ganga River, right? So people who used to stay around Ganga River, they used to knit cotton fabrics to make clothes. Then in Egypt, along with the cotton, flax was also used to make fabric. Do you know flax seeds? No, nowadays flax seeds are of great benefit. If you mix flax seeds in any smoothies, soups, it is very, very much beneficial because flax seeds contain omega-3 fatty acids, which is available in fishes and as well as flax, which is very beneficial to your brain. So these omega-3 fatty acids helps your brain to get it stronger, your memory gets sharp. So those flax fibers were also used along with the cotton in the ancient Egypt. So suppose if you are making any salads, you are making any smoothies like milkshakes or soups, you must add roasted flax seeds to it, or you can even add roasted flax seeds powder. The flax seeds are free of fat and cholesterol as well. Flax provides you lots of nutrients. They are brown colored seeds. So then ancient people didn't know about stitching process. So nowadays we know about the stitching process, but the ancient people didn't know. So they used to drape the fabric. Drape means just covering over the body without tying it in a specific manner. So with the invention of needle, so after the needle, the steel colored needle, if the stitching is done, after the invention of needle, stitching process started. Then different fabrics were woven. So even in nowadays, without weaving into a fabric, still unstitched fabrics are draped, like sari. Sari is a simple fabric, right, which we will drape without stitching it into any other thing. Same way dhoti, same way lungi, all these are pieces of fabrics. Without stitching them into any other structures, they are directly draped. Then turban, Punjabi people usually six wear turbans over the head. That is also nothing but a piece of cloth. All these are modern day unstitched fabrics. So we can conclude that there are large varieties of fabrics available all over country, and then depending on the climatic conditions, you can wear different types of fabrics. If it is winter, you can wear wool. Then if it is summer, you can wear cotton fabrics like that. So this is the history of clothing material. This is about the chapter how fiber is made into fabric.